Hi guys, and very glad to welcome you again on our channel. These are hottest news from crypto world, so be aware of all the latest news about cryptocurrencies together with me. Let's get down to business right now. Why Bitcoin is poised for a powerful bullish breakout above $60,000? Bitcoin price is consolidating gains about $58,000 resistance level against the US dollar.
Bitcoin failed to settle above the $59,500 resistance level and recently began a downward correction. BTC broke through the $59,000 level and even traded below support at $58,500. However, the bulls were active near support at $58,000 and the 100-hour simple moving average. The low formed near $57,922 and the price appears to be trading in a contracted range. It has already recovered above the $58,500 level. There has been a breakout above the 50% Fib retracement level from the recent drop from the high of $59,665 to the low of $57,922. Bitcoin now faces resistance near the $59,200 level. It looks like a critical narrow triangle has formed on the hourly chart of the BTC-USD pair, with resistance near $59,200. The triangle resistance is near the 61.8% Fib retracement level from the recent decline from a high of $59,650 to a low of $57,922.
Parsec announced new lending and borrowing protocol. Parsec launched its revolutionary IQ protocol on the Test Network.
Parsec has launched its revolutionary IQ protocol on the DAS network, a decentralized financial solution for the SaaS market. The IQ protocol is the world's first risk-free and collateral-free DeFi protocol for tokenizing SaaS subscription in the DeFi space with a circular economy. The IQ protocol includes several standard DeFi services, including staking, lending, and borrowing. The IQ protocol breaks new ground for DeFi solutions in the core environment. Not only is the protocol's network maintains completely unreliable, but the protocol itself is open source. In addition, the Parsec team is considering running the core network on several other networks, including Binance Smart Chain and Solana, with which Parsec is already integrated. IQ Protocol is also taking an innovative approach to the use of tokens through the introduction of Power Tokens. Power Tokens are housed in Power Enterprise, a series of smart contracts that combine several features of the IQ Protocol, including management, funding, and the ability to mint new power tokens.
Ethereum revisits $2,000 where the bulls aren't done yet. Ethereum gained bullish momentum and broke $1,950 resistance against the US dollar.
Ethereum remained well above the $1,850 level and, unlike Bitcoin, traded to a new weekly high. ETH broke through many important barriers near the $1,920 and $1,950 resistance levels. There was also a jump above the $2,000 level and the price positioned above the 100-hour simple moving average. A high was formed near the $2,008 level and price is currently consolidating gains. Initial downside support is near the $1,980 level, the 23.6% Fib retracement level from the recent increase from the low of $1,888 swing to the 2008 high is close to $1,980. A key bullish trend line is also forming with support near $1,945 on the hourly chart of ETH USD.
Polychain leads DeFi lending protocol Greenwood's $2 million seed round. Decentralized financial lending protocol Greenwood has raised $2 million in a seed round led by Polychain Capital.
The firm announced in a post that other investors involved include Blockchain Capital, Robot Ventures, and Divergent Ventures. Greenwood also received individual contributions from Ricky Lee, co-founder and crypto trading firm Autonomy, and DeFi Aave Credit Protocol founder and CEO Stanny Kulachov. The first phase of Greenwood's version 2 protocol, which is currently live but has yet to be audited, involves entering into a series of smart Ethereum contracts to borrow from Aave or Compound, whichever protocol has the lowest instantaneous interest rate per year. The goal is for users and dApps to be able to borrow crypto assets through DeFi at the lowest interest rate without having to calculate interest rates themselves.
South Korea to implement COVID-19 blockchain vaccine passport. The South Korean government is seeking to issue COVID-19 vaccine passports with a blockchain to vaccinated citizens.
Starting this month, the South Korean administration plans to release a digital certification system based on blockchain technology to verify a person's coronavirus vaccination status through a smartphone app. The introduction of the vaccine passport or green pass will allow only those who have been vaccinated to experience recovery in everyday life. The vaccine support would encourage people to experience a sense of return to normalcy. Chang acknowledged that the security of the system will be enhanced by blockchain technology. As a result, identity theft will be eliminated and transparency will be increased.
Bitcoin's mining difficulty adjusts to record high as new miners come online. Bitcoin's mining difficulty showed a moderately large increase.
Data shows that the network mining difficulty adjusted to 23.14 trillion at 2 a.m. UTC on April 2nd, a 5.82% jump from its March 20 record. The latest adjustment is the largest percentage adjustment since January 9th, signaling that more Bitcoin mining equipment has recently hit the market and has subsequently been plugged in. Indeed, the average 14-day hash rate on the Bitcoin network has increased from 156 exahashes per second on March 20 to 165 exahashes per second currently. This means that all the miners securing the Bitcoin network are doing an average of 165 million trillion hashes per second to calculate the correct answer for mining a new block. The new 9 exahashes per second of computing power over the past 2 weeks is equivalent to about 90,000 units of the latest generation of Bitcoin mining equipment, such as the Bitmain and Miner S19 Pro.
Coinbase expects a direct listing on April 14. The San Francisco-based company could become the first public crypto exchange in the US.
US-based crypto exchange Coinbase said it expects to go public with a direct listing in 2 weeks. According to Coinbase's blog, the US Securities and Exchange Commission, or SEC, announced that the S1 cryptocurrency exchange registration for public offering has gone into effect. Coinbase's Class A common stock is expected to trade on the Nasdaq Global Select Market under the ticket symbol COIN on April 14. The crypto exchange was previously expected to go public in March, but reportedly responded its plans after paying a $6.5 million fee as a part of settlement with the Community Futures Trading Commission. The firm could have a valuation of $100 billion at the time of its initial public offering, as suggested by the stock exchange, which reportedly sold for $375 each in a private auction last month.
Court allows IRS to request customer records from crypto firm Circle. The Internal Revenue Service is requesting customer records from crypto firm Circle to see if US residents are meeting their tax obligations.
According to an April 1st statement from the Justice Department, the IRS plans to serve a summons on John Doe, Circle, and its affiliates. The statement explicitly mentions Poloniex, which Circle acquired in 2018 and deployed the following year. According to the statement, the IRS is seeking information on U.S. taxpayers who conducted the equivalent of $20,000 worth of cryptocurrency transactions between 2016 and 2020. The IRS is seeking records of Americans who did business with or through Circle, a digital currency exchange headquarters in Boston. The John Doe call does not include the names of those being investigated, and it gives the IRS the authority to request information on taxpayers it has not yet identified. This allows the IRS to get the names and information on taxpayers who fell into a particular group, such as a list of investors who could potentially violate tax laws. This requires the signature of a federal judge.
Morgan Stanley has approved Bitcoin investments for a dozen new funds. The multinational investment bank expects to add Bitcoin exposure to its funds through futures.
certain funds may be exposed to Bitcoin indirectly through cash-settled futures or indirectly through investment in Grayscale Bitcoin Trust, a private investment vehicle that invests in Bitcoin, the documentation said. The bank also noted that investments in Bitcoin, whether through futures of GBTC, would be arranged through a wholly owned subsidiary exempt under Cayman Islands law. In a statement, Morgan Stanley listed 12 funds it plans to transfer to Bitcoin, including the Advantage portfolio, the Asian Opportunity portfolio, the Global Counterpoint portfolio, the Opportunity Development portfolio, the Global Advantage portfolio, the Global Opportunity portfolio, and others.
So guys, these are all news for today. I hope that you like our video. If you still have any questions, please ask them in our comment section below this video. Have a great day. I wish you good luck. Bye.